Thank you guys for watching Destination Hamzik. Me and Emma, and whoa, Emma's very excited to go to Greer, Arizona and check out that very, very cool weather. Are you ready for another adventure, Emma?
Ugh.
Oh, did you poop? Rolling green hills, big and beautiful lakes, lush forests, let's be honest, those words would never describe Arizona, right? Well, wrong. Most people tend to think of desert and heat as soon as they hear Arizona, and while it sure has plenty of that, it also has this. Today, we're exploring a place that not even many people from the state know of, a little hidden gem of Arizona. Welcome to Greer.
I haven't actually heard about Greer until recently, but what's really awesome is that it's about 60 degrees right now in Greer. It's about 100 right here in Phoenix. So in about 4 hours, the difference in temperature is gonna be crazy drastic.
Toilets here at this Chevron were so weird that when you pee in it, all the water flies back at you. All my legs are wet. Yeah, from my pee. You better wash yourself. Okay, this is parenting life. We've been here for 30 minutes trying to get this big ass booger out of Emma. We finally managed to get it. Look how big.
Looks like you're not recording Emma's boogers.
Look how big that sucker is. That came out of this little small baby right here. Look at that. All right, we got one more booger to go. When they ask us, so what's different when you travel with kids? What do you usually do when you travel with kids? This is what you do. You stop at a random gas station in the middle of nowhere and you pick boogers out for about 45 minutes now. That's my life now. Oh my God. I'm done. So we made it to Greer, but we are in the middle of nowhere. I have not seen a gas station for a very long time, and I'm actually running out of gas. So it's freaking beautiful. This is like one of the most beautiful places I've seen in Arizona, actually. Rolling beautiful untouched hills. But right now where we're going, it is middle of nowhere. I haven't seen any restaurants. I haven't seen any gas stations. Look at this. Some of these places look freaking old. The heck is that? That used to be a gas station like 150 years ago, it looks like.
So after getting kind of lost, we finally made it here to the cabin. The address on the Airbnb wasn't really accurate. It's beautiful, beautiful, chilly weather. The sky up there looks a little orange. There's thundering in the back. It looks like it's gonna rain.
Let's celebrate. Emma, cheers. You're so freaking cute.
So one of the top dinner options here in Greer is Molly Butler, but you gotta be careful because it's only open until 9 p.m. So it's almost 8 p.m. right now, so we gotta rush out to Molly Butler, which is like 5 minutes away, and have dinner because we're starving. Dude, it is so busy here. It's a 30-minute wait, but it's just popping. Crazy busy, crazy popping, and they're only open till 9. So.
And we didn't think Emma could sleep anymore, but
Emma's been passed out all freaking day. All right, here at Molly Butler, one of the most famous and best restaurants here in Greer. I'm very, very ready for the food.
Best things on the menu is the chili. They also serve a loaded version. That's what Stephanie got.
Yeah, I got this. Tastes like my dad's chile colorado from Las Vegas. It's really good.
The most famous thing on the menu right here is Molly's prime rib cooked medium. Let's be the judge of this bad boy right here. Just falls apart. Oh, that's very salty.
I don't like salty.
It's so soft. It is crazy soft. They put in the sauce. That's good. That's good prime rib. I mean, I gotta say, that was amazing food.
this Molly Buckler a must eat here in Greer. You gotta come here, try your prime rib. Honestly, we got the pasta, we got Molly special, even the wings. Marissa, who's very boring over here, she's the most boring eater in the world. She got wings, even the wings were good. So everything's been amazing. So we're back at the cabin. There's some thunder in the distance. It might rain tomorrow, so I'm actually looking forward to that. Hopefully it doesn't rain the whole day, but if it rains maybe in the morning or late at night, we're gonna wake up to some very, very fresh greens. Right now, we're just gonna have some beers, chill, and just look out into this very pitch black night with no sounds, only me rambling on. The occasional animal howl. Beautiful area. I have no idea how. I've only heard of Greer 2 weeks ago. I think that this is the hidden gem of Arizona. Skip Flagstaff, skip Pine Top. They're nice places, but skip all of them actually. Come to Greer. This place is amazing. It's a little freaky in this cabin, and we heard something moving over here on the side. So I'm gonna shine a flashlight. Probably just an animal.
Good morning, Emma.
So it is actually 10:30 in the morning right now. We slept in. I didn't really sleep that much last night. We put Emma to bed like around 12:30. I was tossing and turning for some reason, I don't know why. And then woke up at 6, fed Emma, changed her. She kind of went back to sleep an hour later. So I really needed that couple more hours of sleep to really function. We are up now. And we have another dilemma.
So the issue now, I have about 50 miles left in the gas tank. The Pine Top is an hour away, and there is no gas stations here in Greer, which is weird, right? Now we have to go to a nearby town.
So I'm lucky that Matt here knows this area because he grew up here, and I don't know, like, I was gonna say.
We found a gas station.
So Matt said that this little gas station has been here for forever, 20 plus years, and he said one of the best things that they have is these little fried bean and cheese burritos. So I even got the hot sauce. He said, you know, it's really good for the hot sauce. These little suckers, check these out. Do they still look the same?
Yeah, that's them.
So I was thinking of getting one or not, and then the lady was like, you want some food? And I'm like, F- it, why not? Let's go ahead and try them. That's a fried bean and cheese burrito.
Oh,
holy, that is so hot. On the road, guys, be careful, there's a cow on the road. Oh, it's a little baby one. So we're here at the Sunrise Park Resort. Matt actually worked here when he was in high school. So tell us what you can do here during the summertime.
So during the summertime, you have zip lining right up here. There's a lot of mountain bike trails.
And then during the winter here, they get what, like 10 feet of snow?
We get a ton of, yeah, sometimes more. I mean, 10, 12 feet of snow.
Definitely one of the best things to do here in Greer. You can take the chairlift. Do you know what's the elevation up there?
So the top of this mountain is over 11,000 feet.
I think destination, Hamzik. All right, so the Sunrise Park Resort here, it actually offers a lot. There's hiking trails, there's mountain biking trails. It was about $39 for a day pass to ride your bike here, to ride your mountain bike here. There's a rock climbing wall over here. There's a huge zip line, which actually goes pretty fast. And then of course you can take the ski lift all the way up to the top of the mountain, which is a little over 11,000 elevation. There's also food here. There's a restaurant, there's a bar. Get your Navajo tacos. Is that what they're called?
Indian tacos.
Indian tacos.
Because they're Apache Indians.
They're coming down to rescue her because she couldn't grab that.
that thing and she went all the way back. She was screaming for help for a while.